Good morning, I'm Pastor Tim Gauger of Christ Our Savior Lutheran Church, and this is your isolation meditation for Thursday, April 30th, 2020. This week we've been talking about the Lord's Prayer. Today we're up to the second petition, the Your Kingdom Come part. That can be a tricky concept for us because we tend to think of kingdoms in geographic terms, but that's not the only way to think of them. Think about maybe the king and his reign over the kingdom. When we pray, Your Kingdom Come, we are acknowledging that there are lots of forces that want to reign over us. They want to control what we think, say, and do. For instance, the material world wants to dictate our desires. Our own sinful natures want to control what we think. Satan himself wants anyone other than God to be ruling over us. When we pray, Your Kingdom Come, we're asking God to do something about these forces that want to control us. We're asking him to do something very important in our hearts and in the hearts of others. We're asking him to come and sit on the throne of our hearts and rule us by his word of grace. The result would be that we and others believe in him and desire to live lives of glory to him. This is what comes out as Luther explains the second petition of the Lord's Prayer. Your kingdom come? What does this mean? God's kingdom certainly comes by itself even without our prayer, but we pray in this petition that it may also come to us. How does God's kingdom come? God's kingdom comes when our Heavenly Father gives his Holy Spirit, so that by his grace we believe his holy word and lead a godly life on earth and forever in heaven. Let's pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God bless your day.